What is Docker? Docker is an open source platform. Docker helps us to deploy the code, to ship the code, and run the application in production environment. In this diagram, we have host operating system, and top of that, Docker engine is running. Docker engine allows us to create number of containers. Container is not a complete operating system. The operating system is with host OS. So number of container only have the required binaries and libraries which supports the application. So let's say example, if I need 4 container, so that doesn't mean I need to install 4 operating system on 4 containers. Basically, in Docker technology, we need single operating system, which we called as host operating system. And on single operating system, we can create number of containers, and these containers hold the applications. So for example, if you are working in application number 1, it will not going to affect application 2 and vice versa. So this provide a complete isolation between number of application which is running on the single host operating system. So in upcoming slides, we'll drill down more on this concept. Docker enable DevOps. That means, let's say example, we have a developer, we have the operation, development team writes the code, deploy the products, but there is a complete development life cycle. So they write the code, they build, they test, and after that they release, right? But between these phases, there is a long time, because sometime the pre-prod environment is not same as a prod environment. Staging has some different version of tool, where production have some different version of tool. These complications take long time to release that application into the production environment. So here, DevOps allow us to reduce that gap and provide a complete bridge between the developer and the operation. So there will be no gaps in releasing the application into the production environment. But the question arises, how it's possible? How we can release the product into the production environment in lesser time? It is possible due to the DevOps concept in Docker. So all the environment, all the tools which we are using in the pre-prod or in the staging phases, that can be created as a single container. And that container we can use to create images. And that image can be simply deployed into the prod. So there is no change between the staging and into the production. So same set of binary, same set of library, same set of tools, same set of application will be readily available into the production environment. So that reduces a huge time and make the company to release their products in a lesser time, and they can easily achieve their deadlines. Now let's talk about Docker container. If you look at in the diagram, one side we have the developer, other side we have IT operations. There is some set of component which is shared between them. That is a container OS. Basically, container OS is coming from the host OS. Container OS is not a complete set of OS. Container OS only require those files, those binaries to run the application. And rest of the binaries, rest of the libraries, rest of the component only reside with host operating system. So this become very lightweight. So container are basically takes very few seconds to spawn, take very few seconds to turn off, turn on, move, migrate. So any operation you are doing with a container, it takes very small time because it's a lightweight operating system. Top of that container OS, we have a runtime. Runtime is a component that allow the container to run the applications. So that is we called as a complete daemons which is running top of that OS is called as a Docker engine. And top of that Docker engine, we have number of applications. So let's say example, we have in container one, a database. In container two, we have a, let's say example, web server. In container three, we have the middleware. So number of container we can create for different purpose. And here, if you look at host OS and the hardware, and container OS lies between with IT operation. So if any issues come with your host OS, any issue with come hardware, that can be taken care by the IT operation team. Developer do not have to bother about this host OS server operating system. Only they have to just write the application and they have to test their own applications. So Docker allows the developer to build their application in a less time, in a quicker way, because only few components they have to concentrate. Let's talk about use case of Docker. How Docker helps the different organization to save a lot of money, to save a lot of hours, to save a lot of efforts. So Docker allows us to come out with the solution for the number of problems. Like for example, in this use case, the company or the organizations having the issue to deploy the number of processes or number of applications on the same server, all right? Because they are getting the conflict issue between the processes. So they came across how we can isolate the processes from different application. Let's say example, I am deploying the application one, I am deploying application two, application three on the same server. Now what is the problem? Maybe the application one processes or daemon conflicting with the application number two and application three conflicting with application two. So this kind of problem they have faced, and they found that there is a solution with a Docker, because Docker allow us to isolate the application one processes with other Docker which is running on the same server. So let's say example, I have three application A, B, and C. So if you deploy the application into the three container, container one, container two, and container three, so it will be never conflicts of application A daemon with application B. All right. So they concluded with that container save their lot of problems. Container help them to deploy the multi-service architecture on the single box. It is possible with the help of container. And they also use this solution for their mobile team, because they have the number of tools which is running on their local machine, some tools running in the staging, might their versions are different. When they release the product into the production environment, they're facing the issue. So what they say, let's have the common set of tools on all machine. It's possible with the help of Docker. You have the images, you have the container, you have the script. So you can just bundle it and save it into the form of image. And that image you can download on any machine, either your local, either your staging, production. There will be no issue of version. There will be no conflict issue with the different script you are using at a different level. So that problem has been solved. And this is a single use cases we have shown here. For more use cases, I think on docker.org, it's given there. How Docker is different from virtualization? What is the difference between their both approaches? So in virtualization, we have three layer. If you look at, we have infrastructure, we have host operating system, and top of that, which is very, very important for any virtualization, that is called as a hypervisor. In virtualization environment, hypervisor allow us to share the physical resources between the virtual machines. All right. Let's say example, I have the guest OS 1, 2, and 3. All right. So this hypervisor allow us to share my resources like my memory, my CPU, my HDD, my IO. So this is a role of hypervisor to share that with this guest operating system. So hypervisor, are many hypervisor in today's world, like VMware, they have the ESXi, open source KVM, Microsoft, Hyper-V, right? Zen. So there are n number of hypervisors are there, but their core responsibility, their basic responsibility is that to manage the hardware resources between the number of virtual machines, right? But here there is one constraint. The constraint is that on each virtual machines, I need operating systems. So there is a ratio of 1:1. If I have the one virtual machine, I need one operating system. If I have 10 virtual machines, then I need 10 operating systems. All right. To maintain the number of operating systems, it will be difficult for any IT operation team. All right. But why I need so much number of operating system? Because I need to run the applications. So it is not possible with virtualization to run the number of different application without installing the operating system on the virtual machines. It's not possible. We have to install the operating system on each virtual machine to deploy the applications. So they came out, the Docker team, the Docker is completely written in the Go language. The Docker team came out from this problem. They thought, why we cannot use the base operating system like we are using the base hardware? Why we can't share this operating system between multiple container? They not called as a VM, they called as a container. So why we cannot share this OS also with container, so we do not require number of operating system running on each container? And that is absolutely what the container is doing, what the Docker is doing. Docker is sharing the host operating system with number of container. So I need only one operating system to run n number of container on single hardware. And that is awesome. If you look at the diagram, we have here Docker engine. And top of that Docker engine, we have number of container running. And that container not having a operating system. It's only having the required binaries and libraries to run the application. So here we have three applications which are running with their own binaries, own libraries, which we require to run the application. And if you look at the virtualization approach, there we have the same application, but they require the number of OS. So Docker container technology remove that layer. They have removed the guest operating system layer, and they have built the technology in a such a way that container can utilize the base operating system like they are utilizing the base hardware. This is a virtualization approach. In virtualization approach, we have staging environment, we have production environment, we have GitHub. GitHub, where we nowadays using it to maintain our code for version control. So let's say example, developer one is working on the task A and developer two is working on the task A. So maybe some part of developer one and some part of developer two should be properly given the version control. So this tool that GitHub is very, very powerful to doing the version control. So number of member of the team can work on the single project by maintaining their version control by using GitHub. So from the GitHub, you can do the number of automation. So you can call the code directly on the your server. There are the number of Git commands. You have the number of APIs where you can use those APIs to utilize your GitHub. So in this screen, if you look at, we are using the GitHub project. So all the codes are placed on the GitHub, and from GitHub, you can using that code to deploy your application into the staging, into the production. So your code is not going to change. All right. And you have the number of project code, which is coming from the staging, and using this all, you're deploying a virtual machine. There is a provisioning script, which is shown in the red, right? So this provisioning script you are using and you are deploying the virtual machine, and this virtual machine can be a production virtual machine. All right. But there is an issue. The issue is that your provisioning script is fine, but it is not mandatory. Your staging environment is similar, or it's the same hardware which has a production environment. Might their version are different, might their configuration are different. So indeed, you have the same script, you have the same code, but there are the chances where you will get the problems. So to come out from that problem, we have the Docker platform. In Docker platform, the operating system and the hardware is not going to play any role in your deployment of your application into the production or in the staging. Because the whole bundle is going to be saved as Docker image. All right. And that Docker image we can directly deploy as a container. And that Docker image contain everything: your project code, your GitHub, your all the tools and technology which is required to run the application. Those everything is with Docker image. And this Docker image can be simply created by the Dockerfile. So Dockerfile is a code, set of code. You can write what are the things you require. You require the Ubuntu machine. You require the Python. In Python, you require the pip. In pip, we require the some set of 10 modules. In 10 modules, I require the web server. I require the a small script to need to be deployed. So everything you can write in a Docker file, and Docker file can create a image for you. And you can take that image and you can deploy the container. So that container can be easily reside on virtual machine as well. So let's say example, on what virtual machine I can deploy the 10 containers. So I am using my virtual machine in an efficient way. So I'm using my virtual machine and I'm using all the resources of my virtual machine. I do not need to create n number of virtual machine. I can create n number of container for my n number of services. So this whole architecture we call as a microservice architecture. Because here each and every services are deployed in the single container to reduce the dependency, to make them loosely isolated. It should not be tightly isolated, because if it tightly isolated, there will be more number of dependency from one service to another service. So if you are doing any maintenance, you are doing the code change, there will be the huge problem. So that's the reason, as much as possible, we can deploy the architecture in the form of microservice architecture. So each and every services we can drill down and deploy in the n number of container, and that help us to reduce the downtime, that help us to, without disturbing all the modules of application, we can make the change in the code for a particular module. All right. So this whole diagram shows us how we can use the Docker image and Docker container to release our application in a faster way. What are the benefits of Docker and container? Docker and container allow us a simplicity. It allows the IT operation to take the benefit of Docker container, because you do not have the number of operating system to manage it. So there is a simplicity. Speed, as we discussed a lot of things about the speed, because you do not have the n number of virtual machine to manage it. So you just have to deploy the image. You just have to create a container out of it and just make it container available into the production environment. That's it. So speed is there. It's very agile. There is a interoperability, because there is a no dependency. So you can easily individual container with a whole complete stack can be upgraded. All right, you do not have any dependency on the hardware. You do not have any dependency on the operating system. As we discussed, it's a portable. I mean, if you created your container or image, you can easily deploy anywhere on your local machine, which is running on Macintosh. You can deploy on Ubuntu. You can deploy on the Linux. All right. It's allow us as a destiny. So it means it's allow as a microservice architecture. So where single services run with a single container without interfering the other services which is running on the other container.